length. You can see this is 20 mm. So one end is A, the other end is B. So you can just copy this, copy and paste, Control C for copy, and Control V for paste. After placing, double click on it to change that value. Fine. So AB is the line, and on this we have to do unwinding for two complete rotations, and we have to wind a 7 cm long string on this. Okay. So let us begin. So I will start unwinding from this part. So first it will rotate about A, it will rotate like this. So till it comes in line with this line, till it comes in line with this line, it will continue to unwind. So I'll just extend this line up to this point. Fine. Then because the lower part is what we want, we don't want the upper part, what should we do? We have to do TR, double enter, and then click on this. We have to do TR, double enter, and we have to click on that. Fine. Now, as soon as it reaches here, what will happen? About which point that string will rotate? It will rotate about B. So again, I have to take circle. Center point is at B, and it passes through this point. Fine. And then what to do? Then I can, again, I can draw a line from here to here. And then I have to do TR, double enter. Fine. So which part do we want? We want upper part or lower part?
Upper part.
Upper part. So it is coming till here, then continuing. The upper part is required. Lower part will go away. Fine. So now we have done for one complete unwinding. So one rotation of unwinding we have done. But he is telling to do it for two revolutions. So once again, we have to continue from here. So now where the center will be? Where the center will be? Center will be A. And it will continue from here. Fine. Now I will use extend command. EX, double enter. I will click on this line to extend it. Fine. And here again, we need lower line or upper line?
Lower line.
Lower arc is required. Upper arc, we have to trim it. How to trim? Press shift and then click on it. Press shift and then click on it. Because we gave the extend command, inside the extend command, if you press shift, it will do trimming. Without shift, it will do extending. Once again, I need a circle. Now this will continue from which center point? From B. So B is the center. It will continue from here. And again, I need to trim. I need to trim which part? Upper part, lower part?
Lower part.
Lower part we have to trim. So again, I have to give EX, double enter, click on this line, press shift and click on the bottom arc. Now it is complete. So we have done unwinding for two complete rotations. 1 minute. Okay, so this is clear. Fine, so we have done unwinding for two complete revolutions. Now we have to do the winding part. Now let us again take a look at the question. So when it comes to winding, we will get the length of string. So what is the length of string? Length of string is 7 cm. Fine. So starting at B, we have to take 7 cm. 7 cm means how much in mm? In mm, it will be 70 mm, right? So it has come till this point. It has come till this point. So this string, we have to wind it on the same line AB. We have to wind it on the same line AB. Fine. So just make this AB line as thick so that you can understand. Fine. So once again, now you have to start winding it. So winding will start from here. So from AS center, passing through this, you have to start. We have to start from B, right? This is having the center at B. It is attached at B. So we have to take center point at B, passing through this point. Fine. So the upper curve, we will get it. And the lower curve, we don't need. So again, TR, double enter. TR, double enter, remove the lower arc. Then now the center will shift to A. From AS center, continue the arc. Fine. Again, TR, double enter, remove the upper part. Again, the center will shift to B. Continue from there. TR, double enter, remove this part. And still, the last part, it has still not touched the line. It has, the end point has not touched the line. So from A, it will continue. And this will go away. Okay. So the dimension is coming in the middle. So let me take it above this. Okay. This text also, I can slightly move it so that it doesn't overlap with anything. Okay, now it looks good. So one more dimension you can provide from B to this point. This is 70. So we can just drag this text and keep it slightly away in the empty place like this. Okay, so this is now done. Now we have to draw tangents and normals. So look at the statement once again. So we have to draw tangent and normals on the curve. Which curve? On the involute. On the involute. At what distance? 65 mm from the centroid. So what is the centroid of a line? What is the centroid of a line? Centroid of a line will be at the midpoint. Yes. Correct. Centroid of the line will be at midpoint. So you have to start at the midpoint. If midpoint is not coming clearly, deselect the nearest point. Fine. And the end point also, if you deselect, you will directly get the midpoint. Now it's showing the midpoint. So from the midpoint, draw a circle of how much radius? We need at 65 mm, right? So at 65 radius, we have to draw. 65 radius, we have to draw. So this is the circle. Okay. So now, where is this circle touching our involutes? It is touching at two points. So let me place a point. I'll place a point here and I will place a point here. I have kept some points there, but the points are not visible. What to do, ma? Why the points are not visible?
P type
command. Very good. So P type command we have to give, and we have to change the style of points. Fine. Only after I change the style of points, the points will be visible. So now you can see the two points which I kept, they're visible. So one point is on the winding curve and the second one is on the unwinding curve. Okay. So at both these points, we have to draw tangent and normal. So for this, because they are parts of the arc, what you should do? You have to take the point and first we have to join it with the center of that arc. So this arc is having center at B point. So from B, we have to draw this. So from B to this point, we have to draw. So this has become the normal. This has become the normal. Now I have to take rotate command. Rotate about this point. Before giving the angle, I have to right click and choose copy. And then feed the 90 degree as angle. So this line here is the tangent. This line here is the normal. Fine. So if you want to name this, you can name this point. Okay. This end point, you can name it as T. Then this point is M. Always MN will be the normal. MN will be the normal. Fine. So MN will be the normal, and this point will be the tangent. Fine. So this point, let us call it as some point, let's say P1. And this one should come for all this. Okay. One should come for all this. So this is M1. This is T1. This is N1. Moving and all, these are small minor things, you can do it. So you just have to adjust it. And this point, let us take it as P2. The other point, let's take it as P2. This is P2. And here the normal and tangent that we get will all have number 2 written on it. So this arc has a center point here at A. So from A we have to join, move this, the center, rotate it again, copy it, angle is 90 degrees. This is P2, this should be M2. Okay. Copy this, this here, this here, this is N, this one will be T. Okay. So P1, T1 is for the first, this one. P2, T2 is tangent for the second one. Same way, M1, N1 are for the first, are the normal for the first arc. M2, N2 is for the second arc. Finally, you can just make the involutes as solids. Involutes, tangents, and normals. These are important parts. So only those you can make it as dark. And dimension lines. Dimension lines also, you have to give this style to them. Fine. This is also solid. Now your diagram is complete. Fine. Now your diagram is complete. So this is done so that when you go to layout, your diagram will appear properly. So when it is printed, all the thicknesses will appear properly. Fine. Solid lines will appear the thickest. Dimension lines will be slightly lesser thick. And construction lines will be the thinnest. Fine. So all these settings are done accordingly. So the first problem has been solved. Is there any doubt? Anyone has any doubt?
Sir, can you just tell the winding, the center of winding?
Winding from outside?
Yes, sir.
So when you are winding from outside, we have to check where the thread is attached. So first the thread is attached at B. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So first we have to draw from B. Fine. First we have to draw from B. So this one, this arc is having center at B. Okay? And it is rotating like this. So when it reaches this point, what will happen? The center will shift to A. So this lower arc, we have to draw from center A. Correct?
Yes, sir.
And as soon as it reaches this point here, once again the center will shift. Center will shift to B. So this arc we are drawing from B. Okay.
And sir, so for the inside one, I got it, sir. For the outside winding.
This one.
Yes, sir.
So that will come from unwinding. Now we have to start from the inside. This one is okay. For unwinding. Unwinding is done from inside. Winding is done from outside.
Okay, sir.
Fine. So this will automatically come. So you start here with A as center, passing through B, you start it. Then continue doing for 2 complete unwindings. You will automatically get this.
Okay, sir.
Any other doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Fine. Recording is going on anyway. So last question I've not done. Fine. So let us next go for the last question. So we have to draw an involute again. Let me put this aside. Okay. Fine. I'll just give this dimension text style. Fine. So this is our next question. Fine. So we have to draw an involute for 1 complete unwinding. And winding we have to do for 15 centimeter string. We have a circle of diameter 35 mm. The M is missing here, right? E is missing. So we have a circle of diameter 35 centimeters. And then we have to draw tangents and normals. to the curve at 98 mm from the center. Okay, so let us begin again. So we have to start with a circle. Now for the circle, do we know the radius or diameter? We know the
diameter.
We know the diameter. Fine. So when you know the diameter, you cannot just feed it. Okay. So after clicking the center point, it will ask radius. What is it asking? It's asking the radius. We don't want radius. We want diameter, right? Diameter is 35. So from the bottom here, you have to choose the option diameter. From the bottom here in the command line, you have to click on diameter. Or the other option is, you can right click on this and choose diameter from here. Now you can see that instead of taking radius, it is accepting diameter. So what is the diameter we want? We want diameter as
35.
So feed 35 and press enter. Now this circle is having diameter 35. Radius it has calculated, you can see. So now we have to start making the winding and unwinding. So I think for unwinding, you people have already done. For unwinding, you must have already done it. So what to do first? You have to take a line. You have to start from the center. You have to take it till the bottom. And then how much length we have to take here? How much length should be? Come on, tell me.
Circumference.
So what is the formula for circumference? 3.14 into the diameter. What is the diameter?
35.
Diameter is 35. So 3.14 into 35. Press enter. So we are getting 109.9 mm. So we can round it off to 110 now. 110 mm. So 110. So this is the length of circumference. Fine. 110. And what is the diameter? Diameter is 35. Now, how many parts you want to divide this into?
12
parts. So we have to take which command? Div command. So div, enter, click on the line. And how many parts? 12 parts. So press 12, enter.
So you can see, why are we taking 12 points, sir?
It's our wish, actually. The more the number of points, the more accurate you will get your involute. Okay. Because circle also we will divide into 12 parts. So that's why we took 12 here. Okay. So first of all, you should decide how many parts you will make in the circle. Same number of parts you want to make here. Okay. Because there was one video I made on physically drawing this involute. Fine. That video is very important. In that, I have explained why that should be. Fine. Why this 12 parts, why the equal number of parts should be. That I have explained very clearly in that particular video. Fine. So let us continue with this. So we have made 12 parts here. Now same 12 number of parts we have to make in the circle. So now which command will we use for that? Array command.
Array.
So first of all, we have to select all these objects. Along with the points, we have to select all these objects. And then we have to give the command AR. Command for array is AR. So AR enter. So as soon as you give AR enter, it will provide you three options. Rectangular, path, and polar. So we have to choose polar option here. We have to use polar option. And now it is asking us the center point of array. So center point of array, we have to click here. So as soon as I choose the center point of array, by default, it is creating how many copies? It is creating six copies. So six copies of this you can see. And these copies are rotating about the center point which we have chosen. So after this, at the top, these options will appear. All the array options will appear at the top. So from the options, in the items, instead of 6, we have to change it to how many?
12.
Fine. So now you can see 12 copies of that have been created. 12 copies of that have been created. Fine. So this is the part we need. Now, what you have to do is, this complete array is a single object. This complete array is a single object. So when the object is single, it will provide us some problems. So what we will do, we will select this array and press X.
Explode.
What is the command X? X is for?
Explode.
Exploding. So now you can see each of these lines can be selected individually. Separately, we can select them. Before exploding, all of them were selecting at once. Fine. So that is dangerous. So that's why we have removed it. Clear. Now, take spline command. What is the command for spline? SPL. Fine. Keep in mind, we cannot use arcs here. We cannot use arcs or circles here. We have to use spline command. So the unwinding is starting at this point. Unwinding is starting at this point. So first point is here, then continue. Fine. Then continue. So continue. Then second point. So on this line, I'm taking the first point. On this line, I have to take second point. On this line, I have to take third point. On this line, I have to take fourth point, and so on. Okay. Next is fifth point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then sixth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then seventh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Fine. Then eight. So before making an array, if you draw text and number this, this will be much more easier. Fine. Numbering will be there, so you don't have to do it. So how many? This is seventh one, no? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then the 10th. Then the 11th. And finally, the 12th. Fine. So all the points have been chosen correctly. Now, choose end tangency from here. You have to choose end tangency. If you just press enter, will look slightly odd. Fine. So choose end tangency. Choose end tangency. Now you can see you will be able to choose the end tangency. I am disabling the ortho so that you can see how it functions. So can you see this end tangent point we can select. End tangent point we can select. Fine. So let me turn on the ortho again because I want this to be vertical. So I just have to draw a vertical line that becomes the tangent. Fine. That becomes the tangent. Now it looks much better. Fine. It looks much better. Next, what to do, ma'am? Now this is for unwinding. Yeah, this is for unwinding. The video was there for unwinding itself. So hope you have done it from there. Now we have to do for winding part. Now we have to do for the winding part. Fine. So when you have to do for the winding part, the length of the string will be given to us. Length of the string will be given to us. So what is the length of the string given? 15 centimeter. 15 centimeter. 15 centimeter means how much? 150 na? 150 na?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So till it is 150, we should take this spline and continue doing it downwards. How to continue doing it downwards? Let me take a circle. Take a circle. And I think I have deselected the end point. End point is required here. So from this end point, draw a small circle. Fine. And then after this, we have to extend this. EX double enter, extend this.
Sir, one second, sir, it's confusing, sir, please. That unwinding part. Sorry, winding, I guess, winding part. You are muted, sir.
Yeah, one minute, huh? Yes, ma'am. So I'm explaining once again. So what happens here is, this length is there, no? This gap. Let me show that gap. So this point to this point. This is the gap. This is the length of the arc, which is here. Fine. That is the length of the arc, which is here. So when we are unwinding for this much, what will happen? This length of the arc. Can you see? This length of the arc, this part of the arc will unwind, no? This part of the arc will unwind and that will come over here. So the string will extend by the same amount. The string will extend by the same amount, correct? The string will stretch or extend by the same amount. And that is why what we have to do is we have to extend this by the same amount. We have to extend this by the same amount. So how to extend this? I can take a circle. This radius I will take. And the same amount I have to extend it. Same amount I have to extend it. So I can either draw there and then drag it here. Or you can draw it here itself directly. If you draw it here itself, it will be passing through this point. So now what I'll do, I'll have to extend this. Extended. Extended from here. And when it comes to here, how much it should extend? It should extend by two parts. It should extend by two parts, right? So I have to take two parts. From this point, two parts I have to take. And by that much, this one has to extend. Okay. And once again, I have to take next how many parts? Three parts I have to take. And the next line I have to stretch it by three parts. Getting it? Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So this much part, each line has to be extended. So one extra for each of them we have to take continuously. Fine. So we have taken how many parts? Three parts. And again, next one, move it to four. Take four parts. So next line should have four parts. Next line should have four parts. Now, what is the length of string given to us? How much is the length of string? 15 centimeter, right? 15 centimeter. So this length is how much? 110. This length is 110. Now take aligned dimension. Press enter and click on this line. So how much is this? 119. Still it is less than 150. Still it is less than 150. So this one, 128, still less than 150. This one, 137, still less than 150. This one is also less than 150. So we have to take a length which is more than 150. Which is more than 150. So this I have taken here. Let us check length of this. This length is 165. 165 is definitely more than 150, correct?
165. Sir, can you please repeat this step once again, sir?
The same step. Actually, I have done the shortcut here. So we had taken how many parts here? We have taken these many parts, right? So you have to move this to the next part, extend it, and make it back. Fine. Small steps you should understand, ma'am. So what I'm technically doing here is I'm extending this by the same length, this length between any two points, correct?
Yes, sir.
So this length is 165. So this is greater than 150. This is greater than 150. So what will happen? The string will stop somewhere between these two points. The string will stop somewhere between these two points. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
So we should continue unwinding till that. We have to continue unwinding till that point. So we have to find exactly where it will stop. So let me do one thing. I'll just take this and draw 150 here. 150 here. And then I have to find out how much length will be left out. How much length will be left out. Well, wait. Is there a mistake? I don't think so. Okay. Have to continue. So somewhere in the middle it will stop, correct? So we have to know exactly where it stops for 150. So for that we have to continue making the same divisions. So let me choose this point and I will copy this point. I will pick it from this point, fine. So what I have got here, what I have here is this length, correct? I have picked up this length. So the same length I should continue to place ahead also. The same length I should continue to place ahead also. So you can see this much part is left out. This is the last part that is left out. This extra part we're getting. Okay. So this extra part will wind from here, right? So this length, I have to take on this line. Fine. So what is the length of this line? This is 146.67, right? 146.67. So what we have to do is from this endpoint, the endpoint of this line, 146.64, we have to mark this. Now you may argue that, sir, this arc is round, but this line is straight. How can we mark it straight away? The explanation here is the difference between them will be negligible. Fine. So we all know that Earth is round, isn't it? We all know that Earth is round. But how is your ground? Your ground is flat. The farthest we can see, it appears to be flat to us. But when we go into space and look at Earth, it appears to be round. So that's the thing. So when the arc length is very, very small, the straight length is almost same as the arc length. So that is the explanation I'm using here. So, and then next, what we have to do, we have to draw a tangent at this point. We have to draw a tangent at this point. So how to draw a tangent at this point? First, we have to draw the normal. So this is the normal. Now I will rotate it. By how much? 90 degrees. Fine. I will rotate it by 90 degrees. In what direction? In the clockwise direction. So when you want to rotate in clockwise direction, we have to give minus 90. Fine. Once again, I'll explain. Listen carefully. First, I found the point where we need tangent. Then I'm drawing a line from the intersection point to the center. So this will give me the normal. Now I have to rotate it. Now I have to rotate the normal about this point by minus 90 degrees. When I do that, I will get the tangent. So now this tangent, I need to extend it. So when I select the line and keep my cursor here, you can see there are two options, stretch, lengthen. So I want to lengthen it. So its length I want to increase. So length is increasing. Now, what should be the length of this line? Length of this line, how much it should be?
150 centimeters.
Very good. 150 centimeters. So with this point as, where is the point? The point is, the end point is here. So with that end point, I have to draw a circle of 150. Then I have to trim this. This is where the thread will stop. Now I have to again take spline command. SPL and I have to continue drawing this spline through all these endpoints, and this is where it will stop. This is where it will stop. Now, when you stop, once again, you have to choose the end tangency. So choose end tangency and keep it slightly here like this, tangential. So it looks good. Fine. So here you can see it appears a little odd. It's appearing a little odd. Fine. So for that, again, we have to choose end tangency. So when you keep your cursor on this, you can see there is an option coming, tangent direction. Click on tangent direction. And this direction should be vertical. This direction should be vertical. Fine. So now it looks good, smooth, nice, cool. Okay. So this is how you have to do the winding part. This is how we have to do the winding part. So the winding part, we are starting here at 150. This is where the thread is starting to wind. And as it is winding, this is the path taken by the end point of that thread. That is the path taken by the end point of that thread. Is it clear? Is it clear, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So this is how we have to draw the envelope. I think the second part is a bit complicated. Many students will not be able to do it.
Yes,
in the first trial, it is difficult, of course. But
yes, sir.
We all know the saying, karat karat abhyaste jadmati hot sujan. Right? Practice makes man perfect. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So practice.
Try but don't cry.
Yeah, very good. So you have to practice.
Sir,
yes.
Sir, there is a doubt, sir. Yes. When you start the construction, you will get the small thin construction lines. But when we start now, sir, we are getting that starting only that thick line, sir.
Okay, okay. So what has happened there is, this was selected to solid in the beginning itself. Fine. In the beginning itself, this was selected as solid. When it is selected as zero in the beginning, it will do correctly. So for those who don't understand this, don't worry. I have updated the template on the internet. So once again, go to the link. Once again, go to the link and download it. It should work correctly. Okay. So once again, go to one of the videos which is having that. So go to videos. So I think in all the scales, I have kept that link. So I think comparative or vernier scale can go there. Growing businesses need a hosting solution that is. And then, yeah, here. Download it once again. So this template, download it once again from the video description and it will work fine. Okay. I think I have made a small addition also. I have added this, this text also I have added to it. Fine. So this will be required when you are doing alphabet numbering. Like here we have done P1, N1 and all. Okay. So that you can do it. I don't think I have to explain tangent and normal, right? It's already 11:30, so I think your next class has started. The recording of this I will upload on YouTube and the link to this I will share it in your WhatsApp group. So see you then. By this Saturday, you should be able to complete this assignment and upload it. So those of you who are feeling it difficult to do the last bit, you can skip it. Fine. You can skip it. Even if you do, even if you don't do this last part, I will give you full marks, no problem. So those who can do that, they will of course have better impression for me. Okay. Those who can do it, do it. Those who can't do it, no problem. I will just do the evaluation only up to the first part. Only up to first part, I will do the evaluation. That's it. Only for that, I will be giving the marks.
Sir, in exam, they will ask the last part also.
Exam, because we only will be setting the paper, I won't be giving it, no problem. Okay. I will remove it. Fine. So from that part, you are free. But those who can do it, please definitely try to do it, because we all know that, you see, we are preparing ourselves for the future. we will be engineers of the tomorrow, not of yesterday. So if you want to be engineers for tomorrow, you must be much, much better than the syllabus, because the syllabus which is designed for you all people, it's for the past. Fine. The syllabus has not kept pace with the changing technology. Okay. So you must be much more, you must be able to do much more than what the syllabus expects you to do. Fine. So that's it for this class. We'll again meet Wednesday. And Wednesday, we will start with the next part, that is cycloid. Fine. So please don't keep this pending. Those who don't have a system or laptop, there is an option for AnyDesk. Shoaib sir, of course, is helping you out. And those who can install it, definitely they should try to install and work from home. And those who don't have even a system or laptop, I've told the solution for them also. For the mobile, you can purchase that small software around 150 to 200 rupees. If you spend, you will easily get your mobile working on that. Those who are not even ready to do that, I have kept an option for drawing it on the sheet of paper using instruments and then uploading the scans. Fine. So even after giving all these options, if you're not doing, then it's probably your mistake. Fine. If you're coming across any problem, please let me know. Let me know if you're coming across any problem. Fine. So then I'll stop this. Okay. Goodbye.